Hello there, and welcome to episode 37. I'm Dennis Returns from the Final Story. You don't have to ring in. It's bar for Uncle Sean, Belgium. Probably the best track on the calendar, still. There are some issues with which we're going to need to attend to this episode. We are top of the Drivers' Championship. We are top of the Constructors' Championship. The question is, can we stay there? As you can see on the right-hand side of the screen, the ATR period changes over after this race, and we have completed some research items on suspension and underfloor. We're expecting a facility upgrade for the factory very soon, which will allow us to have more projects on the go at the same time. Should be very interesting. As far as the car is concerned, we've dropped off. Red Bull have gone full send on Max's car, and we dropped behind, I believe it's the Mercs. But we are still good for the championship as it stands. We are going to need to continue developing this year's car a little bit. So, we're going to have some rain. It is Spa after all. What I'm thinking is we're going to try and go out on some medium tyres and some hard tyres during these two sessions, just to give us some feedback on those tyres, because the softs are useless in the race, realistically. Let's just double check the compound performance and expected strat. So expected strat here is going to be apparently a soft medium or a medium to hard. The softs go off far too fast. We could potentially do a soft, medium, soft, depending on how much quicker we are than the other cars. But overtaking here is a bit of a nightmare. What's the pit consideration? Not that much, actually, in the grand scheme of things. But we're not going to make the time back on the lap times, so it would have to be a hard push. It's going to be a one stop, I think. So, push forward, put Theo in the car. We'll throw the hards on for now. Let's throw mediums on. 18 laps of fuel's more than enough. You don't really get to go that many laps on. Right, let's have a look at setup and also the engine parts. Engine parts are fine, we did those already, that's fine. Fuel wise and push time, yeah, that's fine. Setup. Okay, so less cornering, less traction, more braking stability. Sorry about that. We've got builders in, unfortunately. We were as needed. Okay, so during that time, I did a little investigation of what my settings were for last season's Grand Prix. And apparently, that should return me a very nice result for Danny Rick. And for Lando, so, you could call it cheating a little bit, I suppose, but at the end of the day, F1 seems to have the data from the previous year, so why shouldn't I? Okay. So we'll do 18 laps on that, is the plan, and we'll see where we go. Don't forget
radio
to
check.
Like, follow, subscribe, etc. You enjoy the content or fancy a bit more F1 related content. See where the weather's coming in. There is no bad weather this session, which is very interesting. May as well put a set of softs on. Oh no, Teo needs to be on the light.
Oh, he's had a spin!
Apparently I forgot to change that. So I'm fully expecting a mid to high 90s here. The setup requirements can't have changed that much. Not expecting that the cars are going to be high up on the grid. They are using old components, after all, or at the very least, Danny Rick is. I swear I changed them for Lando's car, but we'll see how we get on. Optimal setup. I'll take that. You may as well stay out, Danny Rick.
How's the balance? How's balance?
Great. 87. So Lando has a changed setup. Interesting. What do we change from Lando's setup? Aha. I made an error in copying Lando's setup over. This should give us a a much better example of what's going on here.
That sounds like someone's gone wide there.
Dynamic straight back out, set us off, good to go.
Oh, there's a spin!
How many laps does he in fact need to do, is the question. There's maximum...
So there was a crash.
Okay, understood.
Maximum track bonuses per session.
I think that was a crash. Someone spun out.
I
just want to give a very big, quick bit of feedback. And
97.
Then
we'll so we do need to make a change. So a slight decrease in Overseer. We'll try that. Throw him back out on a set of mediums with 10 laps of fuel in. It's not even going to be 10 laps, but.
We've just had a crash on the track.
Can we pull Danny Rick in, do we think? I think so. I think he's done enough this session.
Someone's run wide! Did somebody spin out there?
So we are looking for an optimal result in either oversteer or cornering on Lando's car here. If we get anything back other than that, then we didn't get anything back. Fantastic. Well, at least we know the traction's still fine. Okay. So, first and foremost, we are able to put softs on. So, hard tyres it is. 25 laps of fuel. Same for Lando. And just hope it doesn't rain, basically.
Just a radio check.
Yeah, all good.
So there's a very high chance of rain in about three or four laps time.
Rain is expected.
Four
so
laps.
This is the rain that we expected. It should be steady and light at this level.
Yeah, confirm.
Well, you say it's steady and light at this level. But I'm not feeling that they're going to get more than one lap in here. It's definitely worth bringing the cars in. Have an optimal. This is a good change. I must apologise if there's any interference in the audio. There is a lot of drilling going on upstairs. Phrasing. Optimal setup for Lando, 100%. Both cars can now just stay out.
Understood.
Until there is issues with the weather.
We've just had a spin.
So Lando is eating his tyres that little bit faster than Danny Rick here. Which is worth knowing. Danny Rick has just about done enough, I would think, for his track awareness for this session. Lando's got a little way to go yet. Ideally, he needs to be up into the into the 40s by the end of the session. Not too hopeful that's going to happen, if I'm honest. Getting more rain.
Looks like the grade
has ended with 8 minutes to go. But the track is not drying.
We've just had a car run wide.
I think we will call them in. Send them both back out on a set of softs, just to use these tyres. Because we're going to be throwing them anyway. And we'll get better data going round on a set of softs than we would on a set of inters on a tri track. Lando's going to hit close to 50%, which is fantastic. Far from expected. Okay, there's engine penalties left, right, and centre here. I'm assuming it's engine penalties rather than. Anything else?
Hello and thank you.
I wonder what sort of weather we're getting this session. Supposedly a lot of rain. I would rather keep a set of mediums here, I think. Let's just have a quick look at the compound performance. I think a medium soft medium would be a better option for the race than a soft medium soft. To be honest, we could potentially look at having one car on one strat and the other on the other, but the medium soft medium gives us more options. So we'll be keeping the medium tyres. And chucking the boys out on the softs.
And radio check.
Yep, radio is good. Drink's good.
There's supposedly no rain till, well, at all. It's just cloudy. So we're looking at rain for Q1, 2, 3, some of the above. Just make sure Danny Rick gives Lando a bit of space here. There is, I suppose, the other thought that we do have a faster car, so we could use the softs to get away. Do an early pit for an undercut.
I think put the hards on. Wide. Did someone run wide there?
Yeah, was that crash? Understood.
There's been a crash. Sounds like a single car.
Let's see what Danny Rick can do towards the end of the session. The tent with 5 laps of fuel in. And a destroyed engine.
There's been a crash.
New set of tires for Lando. He's going to be in the 90s, which is fine. And to be honest, the fact that he's so high up the grid, even with his busted up engine, is good stuff. Gap to put Danny Rick out into. Now we'll do.
That sounds like someone's gone wide there.
So he's a second back with no push and his broken engine. And 7/10 back. Push. Come on, Lando, hit 90. There you go, let's just pull you in now. There's no need to go more than 90, you'll still get the maximum bonus. Okay. So we've just got to put the good engines in, go to quali. To be honest, I would rather put a not so amazing engine into Lando's car, as much as this is Spa after all. I would rather qualify slightly lower and maybe get some benefit from getting up the grid a little bit. I do feel like we're going to need to take a penalty at some point in the near future with regards to the ERS.
And radio check.
Let's check the rain. There is no rain this session, so we will be going out later.
Should be green.
In fact, we will put an extra lap of fuel in, just in case our run is compromised.
Who's running wide there?
We wait till all of these guys hit their in laps, I suppose. So you got Latifi, Bottas and Stroll. And Verstappen on out lap. Where's Verstappen? Verstappen's there. Latifi is behind him. Bottas there. Stroll is on in lap over there. So Verstappen there, that's fine. Everyone's on fast laps, so we can now go out.
Oh, we've had a spin!
So how far ahead were we? 5/10 above 10th. Now, a wet quali is helpful for our situation with the tyres. I'm a fan of that. We'll still keep two laps in the fuel in the car.
Radio check, please, Lando.
It is going to dry up later,
yeah, all good.
So we'll leave it for the moment. What we'll do is we'll throw some inters on. Because that track's not staying above 5 mils of rain very long.
Yeah, confirm.
So our bankers are full.
No more rain.
Okay.
We need the one lap of fuel. For a mistake here. That's okay.
We've just had a car run wide.
So what I might do actually, instead of doing the two flying laps, is I'll send them out straight away with the old tyres on. Send them with the old tyres. Gain a top 10 position.
Radio check. Yeah, confirm.
So it's supposed to be dry the whole session.
Should be green now.
Is everyone out? Everyone's on an out lap, so we shouldn't be compromised. We've got a nice gap to Hamilton. Lando's going to have got a big toe there. So we're aiming on the toe for Danny Rick here. Takes third. Where's Hamilton? Out. That's fine. Okay, so, of course. Both starting with grid penalties.
Has arrived and
so I do wonder, is it worth throwing the grid penalties in now? To be honest, I think probably not. I think we'll take the cars as they are. Let's have a look. So, a soft to medium is not the quickest strategy, but going long on the mediums is slightly quicker. No, we'll go short. Now, a soft, medium, soft, however. Okay. And what if we went medium, medium soft? It is the same. So, we will take strat A. That's the option. There is no alternative. The undercut is going to be powerful here. So, I say the undercut's going to be powerful. We can wear the tyres out a little bit. We've got the time and space to do that. So we could look at DRSing the two cars. Lane for lap 20. Lap 20. Throw a bit more fuel in the car. However, I do remember that in Spa, you can overfuel too much. So, there we go. Danny Rick starts on pole again. So the race we go. No sign of rain.
As the sun continues. You can hear the excitement in the crowd here at the Belgian Grand Prix.
Lando is parked angling at Danny Rick.
It's
That's
lights
gonna
out
be
and away we go.
So that Ferrari is causing Lando some issues. Like why they'd be using 89% softs, I don't know, but how far can we get ahead of that Ferrari? Verstappen has started so far back. We need the DR, we need the deploy. We have to get further ahead than what we are. Safety car, safety car.
Safety car.
Question is, where is the safety car?
Several cars involved.
The safety car has not come out.
Latifi, stop there.
Okay,
so that's a full course safety car, with the safety car having not been catching us at the end of the first lap.
Looks like there's been a lockup.
There is a possibility safety car
no
ending
safety
right
car in this lap, and it will be brake bands -5.
Where are we? Okay, big push, Danny Rick. Big push, big push. Deploy and big push. What we need is to not fight teammate Lando. You are free to fight once you've got a second gap. Preferably a 2 second gap, but. Okay. Let's not take it all out the tyres now.
At the moment, we are the fastest car on track.
Actually, you know what? Let's still do a deploy.
So, deployed, deployed.
Understood.
No, you do need to push, boys.
So we need
you
to
do
push.
Need to push.
Understood.
Science does have the potential to cause us problems here. Ferrari's too close for my liking.
DRS is enabled.
Sainz is booting it. Lando, you can drop the tyres off a little bit. So we do have an overfueling problem here.
Was that a lockup on the track?
So we can take away the no fighting of teammate here. No overtake planned by Lando, which is a little bit problematic if I'm honest. Sainz being sat there is going to cause us problems. Sainz is too far back to make the overtake. That's okay. Yellows in sector two.
I think we've had a car run wide.
What's Danny Rick able to do here? We're going to have some overtaking. Not in this section. Danny Rick's gone. I'd like to think we're going to have an overtake every lap. And they'll be stopping off Sainz from being able to get near. But we shall see. We are pulling Sainz along, and that car is very strong. Lando looking for the overtake early. The fortunate thing for us is we're pulling away from the chasing pack. And Lando is through. It's very close set of lap times. Verstappen's far too fast, I don't like it. Is Lando going to allow Danny Rick through again? I would like to think he will. So we can get these overtake points in. I'd quite like to have 20 odd overtakes per car here. So what we'll do is allow teammate through. Oh no. Well, that was an error.
Ferrari, advance the race position.
Ferrari's quick. That Ferrari's really quick. What's Lando capable of here? Can Lando do him into Lecoq? Oh, into Puon, no. Down into the hairpin. We just don't seem to have that straight line speed out of the slow corner that the Ferrari's got. Lando's losing ground here. Come on, Danny Rick, fight it. Fight for it at all.
Oh, and Ferrari just gained a place.
Still pulling away.
And McLaren with a great overtake.
We are approaching the pit window. I do wonder, is it worth trying to bring Lando in a lap early here? Right, Danny Rick. Deploy. And defend. Defend hard. Nope, he's not got it. Right.
Advance the race position.
I wonder, can we stay close and save tyres? Because to me it appears we can. No dive. that we need to push harder. We'd be coming out in 10th at the moment. Big push now, boys, big push. Science is gone. Oh, if that's a safety car.
Yellow flags where you are.
Yeah, confirm.
So there is the possibility that Danny Rick may pull out in front of Science here. He has not pulled out in front of Science. That's a pain.
Charge button on.
Okay.
You're doing a good job.
McLaren, gain a position!
And McLaren with a great overtake.
So we just save a little bit of ERS, save a little bit of tyres.
Oh, Oh, and Ferrari just gained a place.
Just hang on the back. I'll let the tyres do all the work later on. Save ourselves some ERS here.
McLaren, gain a position!
Just be careful with this tyre.
Yeah, all good.
Ferrari, advance the race position!
Well, we'll look at pulling back some tyre wear here as well. Maybe not that much. Oh, science is gone.
Someone's run wide.
This should be a very easy way down now. to the end of the race. Come on, Lando, get yourself an overtake, mate. You're not going for an overtake. Fantastic. Well, we'll just keep Lando saving some tyres for now. 2% and 5% ahead of the pack. Verstappen obviously lighter on his tyres right now. Need a pit later. Let's have Lando go by. Come on. Some overtakes, please, boys. Nope, not planning on doing overtakes. Alright. Settle in for the long haul now. Let's have you do an overtake, Lando. Come on. No. No overtakes. Fantastic.
Charge off, please.
Cool.
So we'll push with Lando just going into Radeon here, or not, as the case may be. Danny, he's got the overtake done into turn one. What's Danny Rick going to do here then? Nothing. Right, okay, that's fine. Let's save some resources. Don't like the speed that Max is catching. So Max's laps are realistically a second quicker. That's not good.
I think someone's run wide.
Let's push for an overtake here, Danny Rick. the job done by the look of it. There we go. Save some tyres on Lando for a little bit. In fact, we seem to be able to hold our own round the engine circuit with older engines. It's good news.
At the moment, we are the fastest car on track.
Good stuff. See if Lando can get an overtake in as well. Oh, oh well. So we are holding science at 5 seconds. The pace that Max has on science is worrying. It's if he manages to get away from him later. Oh, let's drop that Damex pace down a little bit. Tyre situation's perfectly fine. Quite like to bring Danny Ricks back into the window a little bit, but we are looking at Sainz overtaking here.
Oh, did someone run wide there?
That's a big push from Danny Ricks there. Has he gone wide for the overtake? No.
And charge button off.
Understood.
It's still 5 seconds to science. And he does appear to be going side by side with Verstappen here. Pull the fastest lap out. Low flags in sector two.
Who's running wide there?
So Lando pushing, not getting the result unfortunately. Hondo can use the DRS to keep up here. Verstappen has made it around Sainz. That's a concern. We're going to push for fastest lap here.
We've just had a car run wide.
Verstappen's gone wide. Does not appear as though we're going to be capable of the fastest lap. ...144.1 Danny Ricks a 144.1, Lando's a 144.3. Okay, this will be Lando's last opportunity and overtake this next lap. We'll be putting the cars into slower mode, save the engines a little bit.
Sounds like we've had a spin.
Alonso's spinning out, okay. Oh, he's gone for it. He's not going to get the result, I don't think. That was a bit of a silly dive. He should have been going down the camel straight, really. Right, time to turn it down. Up to the end now.
And last lap.
Okay.
And check it flag.
Hold on, guys.
A win for the Honey Badger again.
This was some stellar work from Daniel Ricciardo. Never have a team been more deserving of a podium. Everyone must be ecstatic.
Well, science has us troubled for a bit.
And I'm not sure there's
but
anyone
from a team perspective, that was dominance. Danny Rick stretching his gap once again. We pull away from Red Bull by 21 points. We didn't get the fastest lap, but overtakes, 21 defends. $2.5 million. This is where things get really interesting now. Our suspension. We'll go to Danny Rick's profile and bang a quick modification on here. So we've gained a little bit on there. Decent gain with the underfloor. Okay. First and foremost, we check the boardroom and see what we've got going on here. So we need to push the low speed and medium speed again. We're really going to struggle there if we don't. I think we'll go for maximum on both of those. As far as suspension is concerned, we've had nowhere near enough development with that either. So we will give another push for that. I do apologise. I'm going to have to pause stream momentarily. Oh, no, we'll get away with it for now. That's fine. Right. So, development of a new project in the research department. We'll do underfloor once more. We'll push it's the low speed and medium we need to do. We don't need to push the high. So airflow sensitivity, I think we can drop that off. The same with the drag reduction as well, just to maximize our productivity on this. We're going to go balls to the wall, we'll put two CFD ammos in. This is going to be a main part for us, so we will go with maximum option. It's not really worth the extra here. Well, maybe it is actually. So, as far as time is concerned, in 68 days, so we will have time for another part if we do that. Do that. I think that's the optimal here. 63 days. We'll be able to rush some more developments on later, I think. Okay, another research development. I think we could either go front wing again, or go another suspension development. I do feel like another suspension development might be in order, but we'll do that after we've done the rear, after the front wing, I think. Give that 15. Okay, so low speed, maximize, medium speed, maximize. Brake cooling, I think we'll leave as it is. Okay, that's fine. And we'll do another front, another suspension research after the rear wing, and that will do, I think. Let's have a look at the facility situation. Design center is the one we really need to be looking at, I think. Can't do anything yet anyway. So let's move forward. Some more engineers onto the front wing. And it's manufacturing projects, not design projects, isn't it? Yeah. That's a mistake. Although, to be honest, I feel like that's probably the better idea anyway. So when is 91 days time? 3 months away. Let's go to the calendar. So that's September, October 1. 2, 3. We won't really get another chance in there, I don't think. However, we could potentially get an opportunity if we manage to decrease that time a little bit before we drop the engineers off. So, actually, you know what? It's 15 days time for 5 engineers. Let's do that. And then throw all these onto here. Gives us 30 days extra towards the end, so we'll do that. We've got an extra month's worth of development, in theory. Saving 5 days now. Okay. Memorabilia room being complete is a good thing. Right. Let's have a look at the driver's situations. So, Danny Rick is a long way off for his development points. Nando is quite a way off. Teo's a couple of weeks off as well. About the staff, quite a way off. So, next race would be at Zandvoort. Cheers for watching. We'll call that a day. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow. Catch me next time for the Dutch Grand Prix. Cheers.